মাইকেল নগর শিক্ষানিকেতন হায়ার সেকেন্ডারি গভর্নমেন্ট স্পন্সার্ড কোয়েড ইংলিশ মিডিয়াম স্কুল হ্যাজ টেকেন অ্যান এক্সেলেন্ট ইনিশিয়েটিভ অফ টিচিং অ্যান্ড মেক আওয়ার স্টুডেন্টস লার্ন ডে টু ডে লেসন্স থ্রু অডিও অ্যান্ড ভিডিও ইন আওয়ার ইউটিউব চ্যানেল Teachers of all the subjects are working hard to enhance this online classes in amidst of this pandemic situation. It is a request to all the teachers, students and guardians to click the bell icon and subscribe our channel.
Hello students, today I am going to discuss about class 6 grammar skill, pronoun and its kinds. After noun, in parts of speech, it comes pronoun. It is like noun, but it is not noun. So, without wasting any time, let's begin. See, there are three sentences. In the first sentence, I have written down, Rahul is a good boy. In the second sentence, again I have written down, Rahul reads in class 6. In the third sentence, again I have written down, Rahul stands first. So, we can easily find out that I have repeated the name Rahul. So, what can I do? Instead of repeating the same thing, like instead of repeating the noun, Rahul is a naming word, so it is noun. So, instead of repeating noun, I can use he. So, what is he? He is pronoun. So, instead of noun, which word is used is called pronoun. So, from this example, we can easily go to the definition. So, we can write down the definition. Instead of noun, which word is used is called pronoun. So, what is pronoun? Instead of noun, which word is used is called pronoun. So, for example, we can say I, you, he, she, we, they, it, our, etc. which are used instead of noun are all are pronoun. So, pronoun now comes to the kinds of pronoun. How many kinds of pronoun? Pronouns are 9 kinds. They have 9 kinds. Number 1. Personal pronoun. Number 1, personal pronoun. From this word, we can get one thing that definitely it is about person. Yes, it is about person. Instead of any person's name, we will use or we can use pronoun, personal pronoun. And you know why it is called personal pronoun? There is another one reason. What is the reason? It is generally used of 3 persons or it is generally discussed about 3 persons, like first person I and we, second person you, third person he and she, and it is also personal pronoun, they is also personal pronoun. So just keep in your mind that instead of person's name, which are first person, second person, third person, they are all personal pronouns. So, instead of person's name, which pronoun we will use? We will use personal pronoun. Number 2, reflexive pronoun. Reflexive. What does the word mean? The word comes from reflection. When we stand in front of mirror, what will happen? We all know that we will see our reflection in front of the mirror. So, reflection means when I am going to see another image of ourselves. This is called reflection. Like in the mirror, we will see another me, right? If I am standing in front of mirror, I can see another me. But that is another me? No, this is just a reflection. So, reflexive, the word reflexive comes from this reflection. So, it is easy to understand that reflexive pronoun is the action performed by the subject is on subject itself. the action which is actually done by the subject when the reflection of the subject or reflection of the action performed by the subject is on the subject itself, then it will call reflexive pronoun. And reflexive pronoun is very easy to make generally, or it is we can make reflexive pronoun by adding self, right? Like if I add self plus self after my, then it becomes myself. After you, it becomes yourself. After her, it becomes herself. After him, it becomes himself. For plural, we will use self. For plural, we will use self. For singular, we will use self. And for plural, we will use selves. S-E-L-V-E-S. So, these are all for singular number. And if I am going to use them plus selves, then it becomes themselves. So, it is plural. After plural form, we will use selves, and after singular form, we will use self. See, I heart myself. Here, myself is reflexive pronoun. Why it is reflexive pronoun? Because the action performed by the subject, the action which is performed by I, reflected on myself. So, myself is reflexive pronoun. Then emphatic pronoun. Emphatic, the word comes from emphasis. Emphasis means doing anything largely. This is called emphasis. So, if to add the emphasis to the subject of the sentence, to add the emphasis, suppose subject is doing something, but if I am trying to say this emphatically, then it becomes emphatic pronoun. Like, I myself do the word. When you may have some confusion, like you can ask that myself is reflexive pronoun, again myself is emphatic. No need to be confused. Just keep in your mind that if the subject, the action performed by the subject reflected on the subject itself, then it becomes reflexive pronoun. Like, I hurt myself, I do it, I hurt myself, I draw myself. But when it adds, we just add emphasis to the subject, then it becomes emphatic pronoun. And generally, or maximum of the times, emphatic pronoun stands just after personal pronoun. Okay, emphatic pronoun stands just after personal pronoun, and it is like reflexive pronoun, myself, self. We will add self after singular pronoun, and we will add selves after plural pronoun. Okay, next, number 4, indefinite pronoun. Indefinite means when we are going to do anything not definitely. This is called indefinite. Nothing is definite, okay, then it is indefinite. So, indefinite pronoun do not point out any particular person. I cannot definitely, we always say that I am not definite. It means I cannot point out definitely anything. So, indefinite pronoun means which pronoun, indefinite pronouns do not point out any particular person or thing. Okay, there are many. If I am saying many persons are there, it means I am not telling about particular one person. So, it means indefinite pronoun. Here are the examples: any, more, many, few. These are all indefinite pronoun. And in subject, we can write down like, have you seen any man? So, here which one is indefinite pronoun? Any is indefinite pronoun, because any does not point out any particular person. Okay. And next, number 5, relative pronoun. Which is relative pronoun? Relative pronoun means it actually works as conjunction. joins two sentences. Relative pronoun always joins two sentences. And which are the example? Who, which, that. These are all examples of relative pronoun. And in sentence, how can we use? I have just told you, relative pronoun joins two sentences. So this is the book which I lost. So here, which is relative pronoun. Why? Because the word joins these two sentences. This is the book I lost. So these two sentences are joined by relative pronoun which. Okay, clear? Then go to the interrogative pronoun. Interrogative. Interrogate means we heard this word that police interrogate the thief. It means police ask some questions. So interrogative sentence or interrogate means to ask something. Interrogative pronoun is also used to ask something. And the examples are like who, which, where, but the uses are different. If I am write down the this is the book which I lost, then which becomes relative pronoun. But if I am asking you which book you have lost, then which becomes interrogative sentence. Like who are you? Who is interrogative sentence. But if I am going to write down the girl who sings well, I know, it means who is here used as relative pronoun. So don't be confused between relative and interrogative. Just keep in your mind, relative means relation, which pronoun created relation between two sentences, and interrogative pronoun means which pronoun used to ask some question. Then number 7, demonstrative. In our home, always or sometimes we can hear that if I have bought a washing machine, a fridge, a laptop, then sometimes from this company a particular person come our home to demonstrate about this machine, right? So actually in demonstration they will that person, what did he do? Maximum of the time they demonstrate. Demonstrate means they points out, this person points out something. So demonstrative pronoun is also points to the specific things. Points to the specific things. How? Like if I am telling you this is an apple, it means I am specifically points out this particular apple. So with which word? With the word this. So here this is demonstrative pronoun, because with this word, with the word this, I am demonstrating something. I am specifically points out something. So this is demonstrative pronoun. So what is demonstrative pronoun? With which pronoun we can points out a specific or particular things, this is called demonstrative pronoun. Then number 8, distributive pronoun. What is distributive pronoun? It is actually a pronoun which consider members of a group. There is a whole group and considers the all members of this group is called distributive pronoun. And examples are each, any, etc. Like if I say each of the brothers are very good, it means everyone. It means I am not particularly saying about any brother, but here is not about the all brothers, but about the all brothers. So it means consider the members of a group. And the examples are each, any, etc. And then the last, number 9, possessive pronoun. The word possessive comes from possession. Possession means ownership. This book is mine. It means the book's ownership is mine. Owner, who is the owner of this book? I am the owner of this book. So possessive pronoun demonstrate the ownership. Possessive pronoun discussed about the ownership. So with which pronoun demonstrate the owner, we can demonstrate the ownership, is called possessive pronoun. It is mine. So your mine is possessive pronoun. And one more thing, possessive pronoun comes from my it is mine, from you, it is yours, from our, it is ours, from he, it is him, for she, it is her. Okay, like that way possessive pronoun pronoun makes. So it is possessive pronoun. And let's revise all the 9 kinds of pronouns. At first, from the beginning, definition, what is called pronoun? If anyone will ask you what is called pronoun, then your answer will be, instead of noun, which word is used is called pronoun. How many kinds of pronouns? There are 9 kinds of pronoun. Number 1, personal pronoun, which is which generally discuss about person's name. Relative pronoun, reflexive pronoun, action, reflection of the action performed by the subject. Emphatic pronoun, to add emphasis. Indefinite pronoun, do not point out any definite or particular thing. Relative pronoun, joins 2 sentences. Interrogative pronoun, to ask question. Demonstrative pronoun, points to a specific thing. Distributive pronoun, consider members of a group. And the last one, possessive pronoun, demonstrate the ownership of any particular thing. So this is all about pronouns and its kinds. And now your work is to practice, and your work is to memorize the definition and memorize the kinds of pronouns. Okay, thank you.
Thanks for watching. Leave a like and comment. Subscribe. And do share the video among your friends.